Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, we shall talk about evaporation. In particular, we shall identify the differences between evaporation and boiling and explain the cooling effect of evaporation in terms of molecular motion. When a liquid turns into a gas, the process is called vaporization. There are two mechanisms, evaporation and boiling. Look at the two photos, drying cloth and boiling water. Both involve vaporization of water, that is, a change from liquid water into water vapor. However, there are subtle differences between the two vaporization processes. Can you identify their differences? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Please press the spacebar to pause the video now and list as many differences between the two vaporization processes as you can. Wet cloths are dried by evaporation. Even though the cloths are hung under hot sun, it is unlikely that the water has reached the temperature of boiling point. In fact, wet cloths can be dried indoor. Therefore, we can conclude that evaporation occurs at any temperature. On the other hand, boiling occurs at some well-defined temperatures called boiling point. For example, pure water boils at 100 degrees Celsius under one standard atmospheric pressure. When boiling occurs, we can see bubbles everywhere inside the liquid. It means that boiling occurs throughout the liquid. On the other hand, evaporation is confined to the surface of the liquid only, and no bubbles will be formed. Finally, boiling requires a heat source. If the heat source is removed, boiling will stop immediately. On the other hand, for evaporation, energy is supplied from the surroundings, or the liquid itself. As a result, boiling is fast, but evaporation is slow. The table summarizes the differences between boiling and evaporation. Evaporation is the process in which liquid changes into vapor at a temperature below the boiling point. Boiling is a similar process, but it occurs at the boiling point only. Can you tell another similarity between boiling and evaporation? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Please press the spacebar to pause the video now and write down your answer. Both processes require the supply of latent heat of vaporization for molecules to break their intermolecular bonds completely. In the absence of a heat source, evaporation absorbs the latent heat from the surroundings. This produces cooling effect. Look at this experiment. A piece of cotton is wrapped around the tip of a temperature sensor. When the hair dryer is turned on, there is no noticeable change in temperature. However, when a piece of wet cotton is used, the temperature falls significantly. The wind accelerates evaporation and this produces observable cooling effect. What are the factors affecting the rate of evaporation? Firstly, evaporation is affected by temperature. We know that the mist above a hot drink are water droplets come from the liquid. The higher its temperature, the faster is evaporation. Secondly, evaporation is affected by surface area. It may take hours to vaporize a cup of water, but it may take only several minutes for water spread on the ground to vaporize completely. Thirdly, evaporation is affected by movement of air. Without wind, the molecule in air may return back to the liquid. This slows down the process. Fourthly, evaporation of water is affected by humidity. The conversion from liquid to gas is a two-way process. While liquid can vaporize to form a gas, it is equally likely for a gas to condense into a liquid. A high humidity means a larger portion of water in air, and it is more likely for the water vapor to condense back to liquid water. Finally, evaporation is affected by air pressure. When a cup of water is placed in a vacuum, molecules leaving the water will be unlikely to return back to the liquid. Evaporation produces cooling effects because the latent heat is absorbed from the surroundings. We can view this in terms of molecular motion. In liquid, the speeds of molecules in random motion are different and keep changing due to the intermolecular bombardments. When a molecule near the surface of the liquid gets sufficient speed or energy, it escapes from the liquid surface. This leaves behind a liquid with a lower energy content, which means lower temperature. Question: while evaporation produces cooling effect, which process will produce warming effect? Explain your answer with an example. Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. In summary, evaporation is the process in which liquid changes into vapor without boiling. It can occur at any temperature and take place at the liquid surface only. Evaporation will produce cooling effect. because the process requires latent heat of vaporization, and this energy is absorbed from the surroundings. Evaporation is slow, but it can be accelerated by raising the temperature, blowing wind over the liquid, lowering the humidity, reducing the air pressure, and increasing the surface area of the liquid. I hope this video can help you understand more about evaporation. Thank you for watching.